beautiful friends. It's me, Stormy, and we are going to talk about this lunar eclipse that is coming up July 27th at 4 degrees of Aquarius. And man, what a time are we into. We're just on the heels of another thrown in random solar eclipse. So this definitely makes the landscape of this one a little bit more unpredictable. As well, we've got an abundance of planets in retrograde, and you'll be able to see it on the chart. Just a minute, I'm going to pull it up. And we've also got this in conjunct energy with Mars. We've got the Mars influence happening here. He's in conjunction with the South Node. We've got a T-square going on, the fixed cross energy. So all of this I'm going to tell you about when we pull the chart up. But there's a lot of unpredictability, because Uranus is definitely in the mix on this one as well, that we're going to be looking at and considering as we reach this, this total lunar eclipse. And remember, guys, because this is a total lunar eclipse, the blotting out that happens is complete this time. So it's a complete resetting of our emotions, right? As opposed to if we have a partial, we only go like this, we kind of reset a little bit. But with a total, we're going to boom, black it out. We get to reset, refresh, because something good is coming. The next phase, the next chapter, the next beginning is coming. So I am so excited to jump in here. We're going to look at all of these aspects. I'm going to make this video as concise as I brilliantly can to get you into the information, especially if you're studying. I really want to show you a couple things and to get you out enjoying, ready to get prepared for this lunar eclipse as well. And I just want to show you my beach hat because I was really excited about it. In a couple weeks, I'm going to be going on vacation. So I have a fancy beach hat to share with you guys. So I look forward to broadcasting to you guys from the beach. So I will keep you posted. But right now, let's pull up this chart and check it out. Okay, guys. So like I said, this is going to be about the full moon happening July 27th at 4 degrees of Aquarius with a high influence of Mars energy, which making it already emotional because it has to do with the moon, but then we put in the air of aggression as well that comes with Mars, and Mars also happens to be retrograde, right? So this is a really interesting time with Mars, with some of the frustration, the aggression, the assertion. It's not all bad. There's some assertion in here as well. Because it's also in a harsh aspect to Uranus. So we could have some things definitely come out to the table, come up to the surface that need to definitely be dealt with. And because Uranus is not just an inner planet, it's an outer planet, we could also see some really interesting things happening in our world globally, for sure, okay? Now, I will say that one thing I do like about this moon, as we can see it here, is it just has a really easy kind of subtle influence of Saturn that I think helps bring a little bit of grounding to the table, okay? I think that it's actually beautiful because what it does is Saturn says, hey, calm down. Calm down. And we may need some of that. I don't know about you guys, but we may already be experiencing, many of us, some of the ramp up in this kind of crisis driven, angry, frustrated, I need to say something, I need to do something kind of energy. And this kind of keeps it going, bringing a little bit more emotion. Now, it's not pointless emotionalism, right? It's not pointless needs to say something, to speak up, to move something forward. This is all about, you've been needing to say it, you've been wanting to say it, it's been the elephant in the room for a very long time, and it is time to address it, right? That's what's happening. The stuff that has been beneath the surface is being brought up to be cleared for sure. Now, what we have as we're rolling into this lunar eclipse is we still have active energy from the July 12th solar eclipse in Cancer. So what I think that that does in conjunction with this particular lunar eclipse is it can bring kind of a crisis, or it can trigger subconscious, unconscious things like I just talked about. But also one of the things that happens is I feel like your self-esteem may take a hit, right? And it could take a hit by going one of two ways, where you're like, oh my gosh, the I'm not good enough could kind of kick in here. And you have to see that, no, you are good enough. You're fine. You've got what you need to do the job. Or it could skyrocket and go completely the other way, where your ego is almost in the way. So it's going to be definitely an interesting time to pay attention to. I also want to point out that this is important. This is significant. This particular lunar eclipse is also significant because This is the longest lasting total lunar eclipse this century, which is a big deal because it's going to last an hour and 23 minutes. Why that is so important is that we are under its influence longer than we normally would be. So the effects can be more intense, right? It's the difference between having, you know, a shot of espresso and having three shots of espresso, right? Like the ramp up is definitely, definitely real here, okay? Now, in case you're new to my channel or you're just jumping into this portion of your study, before we break down all of the placements that we're going to see right here, I want to talk about the lunar eclipse meaning as a whole. So the lunar eclipse is still our full moon for the month. And the full moon says that something has to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted, right? But with a lunar eclipse, like I said, it's stronger. It's a lot more intense. It has a powerful influence on things that we keep private because it governs our emotions. That's what the moon rules over, our emotions, our reactions, our responses, things like that, right? Now, at the full moon, what we see is that the sun and the moon are opposite of each other. So we have polarities here. So the qualities are going different ways, my needs versus my wants, my emotions versus my instincts, right? So we have the polarities and they're at a peak at this time. So we have to do something to kind of meet in the middle, okay? Now, like I said, this is a blotting out energy because it is a total lunar eclipse. So it's like a reset to your emotions. You clear away emotional wreckage, baggage, things you didn't even know were there. They've risen to the surface. You say something about it and you get to be done with it, which is beautiful. And it's mostly stuff that has really come to your attention in the last 6 months. So stop and think about that for a minute. As we get ready to prepare for this energy, and certainly on the other side of it, what has been on your mind, in your heart, out of alignment with you for the last 6 months? Because you get the opportunity to work on that. How absolutely gorgeous is that, right? So it's really good stuff. Okay. So let's talk about the actual astrology that we're looking at in this chart. First and foremost, okay, we have got a conjunction here of Mars with this beautiful moon energy up here, okay? And it's in conjunction by less than 1 degree, which means it's a pretty strong conjunction, right? When there's a conjunction that's like 5 degrees away, it's not as strong, but these guys are right here with each other. So this is intense. They are genuinely sharing each other's energy, and it can make it emotionally challenging because with Mars in the mix, I want to fight, I want to war, I'm frustrated, I want to speak up, I want to take action. But this is the deal. Not only is this energy right here with Mars in a square to Uranus, who is very impulsive and erratic on his own, right? It also heats up the emotional energy here. My need for freedom to do it different gets very, very loud, gets very big, gets very apparent. But I'm not the only one experiencing this, right? I'm doing this with a whole globe full of people. So we could definitely see some frustrating energy, people taking out their frustrations, people even just being fidgety if you're around them. It's a very nervousy kind of energy, but I promise you what's beautiful is this did not come to stay, it came to pass, but we need to talk about it, right? Now, as you see, this is this nice semi-sextile aspect that is happening to Saturn. It's very helpful. I think it does help to take the edge off a little bit because it reminds you, think before you speak, think before you act. You've got to be mature. Your actions have to have purpose, right? What's the purpose of why you're doing this? And if you can kind of stop and pause a little bit there, I think that is ultimately ends up being very, very helpful to you, okay? Now, I want to point out a couple other things really quickly too. So if you have your chart, you can grab it and you can take a look at these placements. If you don't have your chart, make sure you either get a free one online or come visit me, stormygrace.com, and order a chart so you have it and you can track as we're going along. Now, this particular eclipse is going to be very important to the fixed signs, right? Especially the ones who are involved in the cross that we see. So we've got Aquarian energy up here. We've got Leo energy down here. We've got the Taurus energy here. And over here, we've got Scorpio energy. Okay, this is going to be happening. This lights up energy for you guys. So if you have any personal planets, if your ascendant is near 1 to 6 degrees of any of those signs, Leo, Aquarius, Taurus, or Scorpio, if you have something interacting between 1 and 6 degrees, it's gonna be a little bit more impactful for you. Okay, it could almost feel a little bit more exhausting for you as well, because it will certainly raise the volume on that eclipse that we had before, and your emotional response to a lot of things, your awareness is going to be very, very high. Your likelihood for having an overreaction or an emotional outburst is a little bit higher than someone who's not sharing those degree placements. Okay, so please keep that in mind if you do have planets within 1 to 6 degrees of those placements. Okay. Now, as we continue to look around at this, we see that the T-square energy that is formed here is pretty good, right? We've got Uranus, who's here. We've got Mars and the eclipse energy, which if you see this bad boy right here, we have a T-square, okay? Now, the T-square energy formed between Mars, Uranus, and the eclipse, make it so that the energy really is not completely stable. Mars is retrograde in between interacting with these energies here, right? So what it does is it just means that things are a little bit more shaky, and can be, what it can actually do is bring any tensions you've been having to like critical mass. Right? And it can be explosive when you're getting ready to try and deal with these things, okay? So let's talk about these piece by piece. First and foremost, Mars in conjunction with the moon here. This is a really strong influence. I've talked about it briefly here, but it can make you impatient. It can make you bossy. It can make it so your temper is running a little bit high. And it can even just put you in a little bit of a rage, which I'm not saying rage like being angry. Yes, that could certainly happen. But it can be so much of a rage where you feel like you have to clean everything in your house and in your car and in your life, and you have to have lost 6 pounds by yesterday. Like, it can almost make you a little bit manic, right? So one of the things that you can do is try and expel that energy through something healthy. Now, like I said, Mars is retrograde. So what this also can create for you is not only frustration because you want to move something forward and you can't, but what it can also bring to you are these events that feel fated, that feel like, oh my gosh, this was just supposed to be happening right now. Random people could walk into your life who are not really random. This is retrograde. You could have things coming back from the past. You could find yourself in a repeated pattern or a repeated person being in your life, and you have the desire to act upon it. You have the desire to interact with them. It could even be painful things coming up, you guys. And the idea is that you need to get into the struggle, because the only way to the other side it is through it, right? Now, I will tell you too, Mars is our planet that has a lot to do with sexual energy. So I do think for some people, this is going to be a time where, whether it's sexual tension, sexual trauma from your past, those events could show back up at your doorstep. And what's going to happen is the events are going to force you to admit that you have been harmed, that you are angry, that it was painful, that whatever it is, especially if you have not already had your peace with it, right? Because this is the thing. In many situations, what happens is no, we didn't actually have a part in the trauma or the drama that happened, but here we are down the road still clinging to it. And that's our part at this point, is that we haven't made peace to be able to move through it and accept it as a part of the story, but not the whole story. And that applies to whatever the trauma drama is. It doesn't have to be sexual, but because this is Mars, if that is something, I want to prepare you. And I want to also tell you with a lot of love that, first of all, you are loved, you are valued. And whatever is coming to the surface is for your freedom. The truth will set you free, okay? So I just love you if you need to hear that right now. Now, another aspect that we see happening is that we've got the moon over here in a square to Uranus. Now, because Uranus is so unpredictable, it's boom, 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 boom. This can be unpredictability in your moods, in your reactions, in your in your reactions, right? So this could also be the kind of energy where you're dealing with it and you feel like, oh my gosh, I just feel like my moods are all over the place, right? Because it can cause impulsive mood swings, right? So this, again, with the volatility of this energy, can make you more likely to lash out. I would tell you that especially in your relationships with folks, this is not the time to be making any sudden moves or sudden decisions, right? This is also not the time. Like I said, you've got to get into whatever is coming up and deal with it, because the natural inclination for us humans when it's uncomfortable is to run, right? And this is even the good stuff, you guys. Let's just say it's all been, you know, BJs and butterflies for you, right? And the relationship is good. The job is good. There's actually nothing wrong. And you want to run. You want to take off. Things that are challenging your emotions and challenging your conception of the life that you can have, the good things can also be a part of your life, that could be challenging at this time as well. And that definitely brings that energy up. Like I said, this the moon in a nice semi-sextile here to Saturn, as we see these placements, I do think that what this does is help to, it kind of provides like a little helper to your emotions, to your anxiety. It gives you that calm down. It says, okay, calm down. Let's be patient. Let's be responsible and reasonable and practice and be practical here. Right? It's all right. Let's just take care of some things. Now, I do feel like with Saturn and the moon, because this is a semi-sextile, which is a pretty nice little placement, you might find yourself actually having issues with your family or feeling like your problems or your frustration are with your family. So I would definitely tell you, think before you speak. You maybe don't want to burn those bridges, okay? Now, as we can see on the other side of this whole shebang that we've got going on here, we've still got plenty of interactions happening in the mix, right? So as we look at this, I just want to say this as well. Because the eclipse, if you go outside on the night of the eclipse, you guys, right? Depending on where you are in the world. So, you know, if you are in the United States, right? Like you're not going to be as pumped to be able to see this particular lunar eclipse. Okay. It's going to be not visible for us. Okay. If you're in North America, this is not going to be as seen on TV. Okay. But if you are in Africa, Asia, South America, Europe, like you're going to be able to just really breathe this one in. But for the rest of us, you know, but if you can catch it online, whatever, but if you go out and you look up at the sky, and you look, this is for my astronomy buffs, right? If you look just below the moon, you're going to see this little glowing orange-ish dot. That's Mars. So the planet is so close to the Earth. It's like, it's so amazing that the brightness kind of sweeps up what's going on around it, and it actually outshines Jupiter at this time. How amazing is that? Jupiter is our biggest planet, and little old Mars rolls around here in retrograde and just takes the freaking show. So it's really cool. But what does that mean for us? That's the astronomy. But what does it mean for us astrologically? It means that the planet that is retrograde energy is going to be felt a lot more than anything else because it's closer to the Earth. Okay? So keep that in mind. That's why all the unpredictability. That's why the tension, right? Okay. Now I want to talk very quickly about what happens with this particular eclipse that you should be doing? How can you use this? What's the best way to put this to delicious use? First of all, we've got all punch of planets in retrograde. Look, you see it. We've got Mars. We've got Pluto. We've got Saturn over here. We'll have Mercury going retrograde during this time as well. We've got Neptune retrograde over here as well. So this is a lot of retrograde energy. So it is still a time of rest and retreat because we are in retrograde time. So think about it. What are you spending your energy on, right? What's the purpose of what you're doing? What's your motivations? Why are you taking that action? If you have fights, if you have old beef with people, this may be the time to be flexible and to kind of, you know, see your part in what's been going on so that you can squash it, so that you can put it down. Above all, I would tell you, remember that irritability, anxiety, all of that is absolutely a part of what's going on right now. It is almost unavoidable, right? Even the most serene people, I think, are going to find a level of anxiety because we're ramped up. Now, if you do suffer with depression, anxiety, any of these things, you may feel like it's a little bit heavier at this time. So definitely, you know, get your magnesium on if that's the way that you handle that, or your 5-HTP, whatever you're doing to treat yourself and stay in contact with those that are helping you, okay? I would tell you too, that because this is such unpredictable energy, to watch yourself, especially in traffic and things like that. Be more cautious to avoid accidents, injuries, things like that. This is unpredictable, irritable energy that is really trying to do some work on us. You know, the closer we get to the truth, what happens first when we get close to the truth, you guys? First, the truth, it will absolutely set you free in the end, but first it's going to piss you off, right? So that's what's happening to us globally right now, is we're getting so close to the truth that first we're going to get mad before we get free, right? So one other thing I would tell you is that if you can, at this time, especially if you do study metaphysics, if you do work in light and energy, or if you're just out there and you're listening to this for whatever reason, give out a lot of love and give a lot of grace. Grace is the slack the universe cuts us for being jerks, right? Give a lot of grace at this time. Don't be tactless. Don't be harsh with people. Everybody is under this influence, and we need to remember that, because we are really all going together. Be the person who releases things so you're not so tense, and you help other people to release their tensions as well, okay? Now, this is certainly the most difficult eclipse of the summer, and it occurs in a landscaping here, you guys, with so many planets retrograde, that really the key is the reevaluation, re-editing, rethinking, introspective work, re-looking at those business plans. But what I would tell you is, as a last ditch resort, tap into the energy of the Saturn Uranus trine aspect. Okay, we've got this business happening all summer long, and it's really going to be helpful to bring new solutions, new innovative, responsible, practical, mature solutions to the table, so that you're able to move forward in a way that's more free. Your personal freedom is not so under investigation. Instead, you're actually achieving it and living it, and you know it, and there's peace. There can come peace out of the chaos, right? So only one more eclipse to survive this season, you guys, okay? But let's get through this one happening right now, and we'll talk about the next one in the next video, okay, guys? Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I hope you have booked your 40,000 subscriber gift appointment. I still have my very big free 40,000 subscriber gift coming to you guys, so I'll keep you posted about that as well, all right? I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the August videos, all right? Bye, guys!